It is now my honor to invite to the stage to invite to the stage the greatest practitioner of this contraption in the back, Mr. Bernard Purdie. We're gonna try a little Vulf tune.
Thank you.
cats up here, yeah. We want to bring out a special guest from Flint, Michigan. Mr. Antoine Stanley. One of my absolute favorite Purdie tracks, and this is the man to sing it.
For those of you needing some inspiration tonight,
here we go.
Are gonna get easier. Ooh, child, things are getting brighter. Ooh, child, things are gonna get easier. Ooh, child, things are getting brighter. Someday we'll get there and we'll get it all done. Someday when the world is much brighter. Walk in the rays of a beautiful sun. Someday when your head's much lighter. Oh, do-do-do-do-do, child, things are gonna get easier. Ooh, child, things are getting brighter.
Do you believe it?
Ooh, child, ding, 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 they're gonna get easy. Oh, ooh, child, things are getting brighter.
Take it off, go.
Someday we'll put it together and we'll get it all done. Someday when the world is much brighter. Oh, someday we'll walk in the rays of a beautiful sun. Someday when the world is much brighter. Ooh, shout, things are gone. Get easier. Ooh, child, things will get tighter. Are gone like it.
Come on, wave your hands in the air and say,
if you need a little inspiration to not say, ooh, child, things are gone. Ooh, child, things are gone. One more time, one more time. Sing it, sing ooh.
Oh,
things are gonna get easier. Ooh, child, things will get right. Ooh, ooh, child, things are gonna get easier. Believe it. Ooh, child, things are getting brighter. Love you, good night.
He'll be back.
But not today! See you soon.
Now, I don't want to get too technical, but Purdie, could you explain the Purdie Shuffle, the mechanics of it?
Are you sure you want me to? All right. You might be sorry. We got a lot of drummers out there.
Actually, who other than you has played the best Purdie Shuffle? Has anyone ever come close?
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Porcaro?
Jeff Porcaro and John Bonham.
There we go.
And I love them both. Simply because it was a nice way to turn it around.
Right.
You know, and I didn't think of it. I hate to say that, but I didn't think of it. They did. But they gave me the credit anyhow. The Purdie Shuffle started many years ago. Now you gotta listen first. The main part, the Purdie Shuffle is a two-bar phrase. It's not one bar. The backbeat is on three of each bar. Believe it or not. For all you drummers, don't worry about the fingers. I'm gonna do that same thing and let the stick rebound for you so you can feel it. I don't want you to write it down. That's the reason. Because you didn't, you might be wrong. It's just supposed to have fun with it. And it does help when your body gets along with you as well. So I'm gonna take it up another little step and take the microphone so I don't have to worry about it. Now, if you hear me singing,
something in the way she woos me.
live. That is Rachel Price. Give it up. The only way that could possibly be better is if Bernard Purdie were playing drums, which he is.
We want to turn the mic over to Mr. Joey Dosick from Oakwood, California, Oakwood High School.
Believe in Jack, give me the ball. I
I'm gonna do one more with Purdie. Let's take it kind of up. Let's take it kind of up.
No, 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 Bernard, man, we just want to thank you from the bottom of our hearts, man. You're such an inspiration to all of us. We are so happy that Bernard Purdie graced us with his presence this week. That is truly called blessing the track. He blessed the whole week. We love this man. Give it up for the living legend himself and a wonderful human, Bernard Purdie.
What's up, Brooklyn Bowl? You here for Vulfpeck? We're here from, I just want to say the mayor's sorry that he couldn't attend tonight, but he sent us here. We have a special commission for VULFCERTS, and for the first time ever, one band has dominated New York City four nights in a row. The four-peat, Vulfpeck!
Thank you, bros. We're gonna do one more in honor of Bernard Purdie. We're gonna do a little, we're gonna take you back to 1997 in my basement, where I was trying to learn MMMBop and I couldn't do it. And I was like, man, this kid's my age and his foot is insane. Little did I know that's a Bernard Purdie sample right up top. So I am going to do it tonight. I'm gonna try to play it. It's a little sped up. Very interestingly, I'm sorry it's late, but it's from Synthetic Substitution and he plays it straight one phrase and then he swings it the rest of the song. But that one phrase is the break that everyone's cut up for the foundation of hip hop. So this one little difference he did, it like changed the course of history.
Exactly what Jack said. There's gonna be a quiz on it after the show. So I just wanna introduce this next guest who's a very special friend of ours. And Vulfpeck, it was some combination of Vulfpeck was actually his backing band on his 2013 tour called Listen Up. And we hadn't actually even played a show yet ever as Vulfpeck. That was 2013, isn't that crazy? It's 2016 right now. And like the guy said, we just did four nights in New York, and it's all thanks to you guys. And that I'm not exaggerating. I really mean that. So thank you so much. And then my good friend, Darren Chris.
What's up? Where's that A440? Where's a 445? Who's got that A?
This is Nick Farrah.
Let's bring this all together. Let's bring the A and Bernard Purdie. We've had an educational evening.
This is perfect, because we got the over 25 with MMMBop. And under 25 with Darren.
Who's
we're
got
about
that
to
A?
Nail this.
Let's hear that A. Yeah, baby.
One, two,
let's take it to 97. If anybody knows this song, oh, Bernard Purdie's playing this song, yes!
So fast, ooh yeah, and you come so fast, yeah, oh, to the
like it's 1997. See you on your feet. Joe Dark's doing something funky. Four nights in a row, Brooklyn Bowl, all the way.
Let's blow it down one more chorus with everybody singing. One, two, three.
You came to see Vulfpeck!
Yeah! That's right. Darren Chris, Melissa Gardner, Antoine Stanley, Ibanda, Joey Dosick. All of you, Brooklyn Bowl, we love you. Thank you to the staff here. We'll see you guys in London. We'll see you next time. And one more time for Bernard Purdie!
In a spot. Victor, sorry.
And Chris, I'll tell you something. If I were a drummer, I play just like him.
You dig it.
Just like him, because there's a lot of things that he does within the grooves that he plays. They may not be audible, but they're felt.
Right.
I do the same thing. And I don't blow a horn that way, but there's always, I'm thinking of everything. I'm a rhythm player, more or less. And yeah. So is he. You know, when I hear that drum core thing happening, and that's sanctified.
Right.
Root beats. You know, that are right in the music, but they're not forceful, you know. If I were a drummer, I'd play just like him.
Yeah.
And me, if I had to play the bass, it would be very hard not to think in terms of both of you.
No, no.
No. It's a fact. It's a fact. Because for me, I had to play, everybody was upright. And I didn't get to the Fender Rhodes until 1960, 61. But upright is what we had to play. They right. had to play that. And boy, did I have a learned lesson to see somebody your caliber of being able to do just that. Either way, it didn't matter how you played it. The feel was there, positive attitude.
And it was very
the face.
Huh? And it was very musical.
And very musical. Super musical. Always.
You know, we got to talk about Aretha. So, yeah, go ahead and tell that story you were about to tell.
It was wintertime, and we went down to Criteria, to Miami, and to record with Aretha. We got to the studio. Our car picked us up, and we got to the studio. But Jerry Wexler, Tommy Dowd, and that crew, they weren't there yet. And so our habit was that if Aretha Martin wasn't there, who had to, he had to learn, he had to chart the music. He had to, because he was the arranger. And so Gene suggested that we just do run it down. Just, and Aretha agreed to teach us the song, Rock Steady. Just teach it to us. Now, she very seldom played on her records, like Marlena Shaw. Great piano players, but they don't play that much on their records. Live movie. And so she sat down and she taught us Rock Steady, which is a very easy song for formatted the way that it is. And one thing about me, Bernard, and Cornell, we have worked so many times together that it's almost like we're three peas in a pod. Mm-hmm. And so after we learned the song, without making a chord chart, Gene Paul set up the dolls and we recorded Rock Steady. And like we did a little thing, just professionally fooling around, because we knew that when Jerry Wexler and Tommy Dowd and Aretha Martin got to the studio, we would have to play it over and over and over and over so that Aretha could get the chord changer straight. Now, Chris, I tell you, from my memory, the song that you hear, Rock Steady, is the demo that we did before anybody got to the studio.
Thank you.
Wow.
Not just that too, but the music that she had fell off the piano. And by that time, Aretha arrived and he was inside. He walked in, put the music back on the piano, and we just continued. And when we got to the break, we never stopped. That was the song.
Wow.
That's what everybody has heard all these years. And we did at least 25 to 50 takes after.
Are you serious?
I would say 50.
Wow.
They tried to make that thing better all day long. Now, we're not complaining because we're musicians. And we're being fed well, the sun is shining, and we're not in New York.
Yeah.
Right. So, but what people hear, and if you listen to that record, Chris, you can tell it's a demo. You can tell.
It had that freshness, right?
The break was perfect. A lot of drummers, when you go to a break like that, they overplay.
Right.
It's a plain old simple, okay, we're getting ready to go left right here, and we go right there. We didn't have anybody over us, no producer, no arranger.
Right.
Great.
This is the Holy Trinities of Aretha Franklin rhythm sections.
Baby, baby, sweet baby.
Holy Trinity number two of Aretha Franklin rhythm sections. Bernard Purdie on drums. Chuck Rainey on bass. Cornell Dupree on guitar. And Richard T on keyboards. Now, I was listening to a Chuck Rainey interview, and they asked him, "Hey, what's the favorite band you play with? You play with freaking everyone." And he goes into kind of a diplomatic, political answer. "Oh, I love so many." And then he goes, "You know what? Actually, the best band I ever played with was that Aretha rhythm section with Bernard Purdie, Cornell Dupree, and Richard T. And this was the group that brought you Rock Steady on a humid day in Miami under the production of Jerry Wexler, who was late. Rock Steady very well may be the funkiest song ever recorded. You know, potentially. Now this band is like kind of the band, you know, already World Cup level. But then we're gonna add Aretha on piano again. and Donny Hathaway on Wurlitzer for Until You Come Back to Me. Stevie Wonder composed. That's Purdie. I actually asked Bernard Purdie what his favorite song he played on was. He said, Until You Come Back to Me, because of that vocal drum interplay that he was doing with Aretha.
There was a period in my early 20s where I thought there was like a conspiracy, because everything I liked as a kid, it was a Purdie, and I didn't know it the whole time. For example, the Mad Men theme, straight up Purdie. Okay, once you leave the house, it's everywhere. Yes. What's another one? Walkies. Purdie didn't play on walkies.